We've had feral animals and weeds in Australia since the first fleet. But over recent years, the numbers have increased greatly, and that's been encouraged by land use change and climate change.
Business as usual is no longer an option.
Look, it's very serious for Australia. Globally, invasive alien species are ranked as number 5 in terms of their impact on the environment. In Australia, they're number 1. Invasions have a huge potential impact in human populations, as we've seen with the recent global pandemic. COVID-19 is an example of a disease that has come out of animals, a zoonotic disease, and infected humans.
We're really looking at how do we maintain our way of life, and also, how do we maintain our identity? We want our bush to look like Australian bush. We don't want to be invaded by a plethora of overseas weeds. Invasive ants potentially can change the whole way that Australia interacts. They are barbecue stoppers.
When we have big natural disasters, it's generally the invasive alien species that can respond and occupy the space that's been created more quickly than the native species, because they're very good at responding to disturbance. Australia's been a world leader in developing genetic approaches to manage pests. We need to see more investment in some of the novel technologies that are becoming available for managing pests and weeds. But we also need advances in digital tools that allow us to monitor and understand how we can effectively manage them in real time. Just like with climate change, we're at a turning point where we need to get on top of the invasive species problem, or it'll spin out of control. We all have a role to play in stopping invasive pests.
It needs to be a whole of Australia, a Team Australia sort of approach.